माई डियर किड्स, वेलकम टू टूडे सेशन। ए वार्म एंड एनर्जेटिक मॉर्निंग टू माई स्प्लेंडिड किड्स, आवर लिटिल लेजेंड्स, वेलकम। सो टूडे वी गोना सी अवर लेसन 7, दिस इज अवर लास्ट लेसन। ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड अवर लेसन 8, आई एम राइट। सो इन दिस लेसन वी गोना डिस्कस विथ हाउ टू मेजर एंकल, हाउ टू ड्रॉ एंकल यूजिंग प्रोट्रैक्टर, सो एंड सो। ओके, सो लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट सेशन इज टेक ऑफ। ओके, दिस टेक ऑफ सेशन they are given the four types of shapes, four shapes. Okay, you have to find the name of this shape as well as how many sides and vertices are there. Okay, so the first figure is square having four sides. So four sides, so this is a vertex. Okay, vertices, we can say vertices. Vertex is single, we can is a singular vertex, plural vertices. Okay, so this triangle contains three sides and three vertices. Pentagon five sides as well as five vertices. Hexagon six sides and six vertices. Okay, please fill this. Come to the angle session. When two rays start from a common point, an angle is formed. Please underline that in this given figure. OA and OB are the two arms. Okay, so this two, both the arms start from the common point O. The O is the vertex. When two rays start from a common point, we can say angle. Okay, so O is a common point, so it forms an angle. Are you clear, guys? So AOB is an angle. How to write this angle? AOB. Whenever you are writing, while naming an angle, the letter representing the vertex always lies in the center. It's very, very important. Okay, BOA also write, but don't write OAB. It's a mistake. Okay, are you clear? The common point should come, or the vertex should come on the center, middle. Are you clear, guys? Now come to the next session. Not next. Or the same thing only, we are gonna see the definition of what is vertex. We know OA OB are known as the arms of the angle. O is the vertex. The simple use to represent the angle is like this, just like this. Okay, angles are measured in degree. Please underline these two points. Angles are measured in degrees, and we use a protractor to measure the angle. Okay, angles are measured in degree. Yes, it's true. Okay, please underline, tick it. Okay, and please underline these three things, very, very important things. Okay, vertex, the point where the arms of the angle meet. Degree, standard unit of measuring angle. Protractor, an instrument used to measure angle. Okay, next we're gonna see how to measure angle using protractor. Last class I inform you to bring buy one protractor, right? I know, guys, you brought already. So please take it. It's a protractor. So it contains two sets of values, am right? Two sets are there. So two scales are also there. So inner scale and outer scale. You always remember, you use your inner scale. Okay? Use your inner scale. So first we gonna see how to measure the angle. So before measuring, see here, start from your right hand side to left. Okay? Use the 0. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, likewise. Okay? So use the inner scale. Okay, here we have the one question. Here we gonna measure this angle. Okay, are you clear, guys? Now just keep this protractor above this figure for your understanding. Next we can see this example given in exercise problem given 7.1. just okay. So, how to measure angle? This both the baseline of this protractor as well as this baseline should coincide together, should come together. Okay? Are you clear? So, if you want to measure the angle, what do you want to do first? Keep this baseline of the protractor should coincide with the baseline of this angle. Okay? Are you ready? So, take exercise 7.1, page number 105. We're gonna see the B problem. Okay? So, say 7.1, here we can't keep the protractor as usual because you are the beginners of using this protractor. So, for easy of understanding. So I use the problem. Okay. So keep the protractor. Both the this baseline. You can see the baseline. Am I right? This baseline. This straight line is there. Am I right? So this baseline and this baseline should coincide together. So keep the protractor on this baseline. Now just measure. Okay. Keep this. Now you're gonna measure this angle, okay? So use the inner scale. So 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. This line lies between 50 and 40. So mark between 40 and 50. So this line lies between where, ma? See, keep the protractor and see. So it lies 45. Okay, so it's exact lies on the 45. Keep the point, so it is correct. So write the answer here, 45 degree. Okay, likewise, see, let's see the next session, next one more example. Okay, keep the baselines together. Okay, now measure it. So what is the angle here? Yes, keep the protractor. Yes, so it lies on where, ma? It's 70. So right here, 70. Okay, are you clear? Likewise, do the remaining example. Okay guys, so exercise 7.1 is a homework session for you. Please fill it and send to me. Okay, next we gonna see how to draw an angle using protractor. Okay guys, our next session deals with drawing an angle using protractor. So first you want to draw an angle of 75 degree using protractor. Let's see how. Okay, so before that we should read the steps once. Draw a ray OA. Place the protractor on OA such that midpoint is at O. See the ray OA. The ray OA you need to draw and keep the protractor. So place the protractor above that. We're gonna draw in a paper. Before that, I'm just explaining. Wait, okay? So OA such that in the midpoint, you need to keep this midpoint, this center line at O, and the ray OA coincide with the degree 0 degree on the 0 degree on the protractor. Okay? Mark a point B near the edge of 75 degree, and counting from the right. On the inner scale. Okay, now let's see. All of you guys, you take your one plain note. Okay, plain note, your max note, please take that and take your protractor, pencil and eraser with you. Okay, shall we start? Okay, as given the steps, the very first one is draw a ray OA. So this is O and this is A. Okay, draw like this. Are you clear, guys? Yes, draw a line like this. Now, place the protractor OA such the midpoint. So, place the protractor. I am already informed you, keep the both the baseline should come together. So, keep the baseline. So, both the baseline will coincide. Okay, coincide together. Now, mark the 75. From your right to left, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 50, 70 is here. We need 75, am right? So 75 lies between 70 and 80. So 75 means in between. See that one lengthy line is there, am right? It is 75. This is 71, 72, 73, 74. The lengthy line is 75. It is in the middle. So it is lengthy. So please mark above that. Keep on point. Okay. From O, draw a join this. Okay. From here, O. And draw a line like this. This is ray. Okay, we can call this as ray. So this is A and so this is B. Okay, so now two rays are there. This is a vertex and here is the angle. Okay, so how to write the angle? The angle AOB is equal to 75 degree. Are you clear? This is a way of measuring, so drawing angle using protractor. Are you clear, guys? So for your practice here, more examples are there. Try to finish this, okay? So next session is types of ankle. The first one is zero ankle, okay? When, listen very, very carefully, okay? When two arms of an ankle overlap each other, the angle formed between them is zero. For example, we know the how is the ankle. Just roughly I draw for you. This is a baseline and this is a two rays, am I right? O, A and B. When these two rays come together, they are coincide. Overlap means one above the other. Okay. When these two rays come closer, one above the other is called overlapping. Okay. When these two rays come together, so there is no ankle, am I right? No vertices. So this is called zero ankle. Are you clear, guys? Remember the zero angle. When two angles are overlap means one above the other. This is overlapping. Okay, one above the other. So this is called zero angle. So angle formed between them is zero angle. Okay, next one is acute angle. Acute angle. An angle which measures between 0 degree and 90 degree is called acute angle. For example, PQR is equal to 40 degree. Acute, the angle between 0 to 90. The angle between 0 to 90 degree is called acute angle. Are you clear, guys? So please underline this. Please underline this. This line also very, very important. Next, come to right angle. An angle measures exactly 90 degree. Exactly 90, okay? This middle line and this middle line will come coincides, okay? See like this. So, this is called right angle. Okay, L shape. Remember the L shape, okay? An angle which measures 90 degree is called right angle. For example, PQR is 90 degree. Here the PQR is how much ma? 90 degree. Are you clear? Next, obtuse angle. An angle which measures between 90 and 180. Above 90. So it comes to left side. Okay. So from 90 to 190. From 90 to 190 we can call this angle as obtuse angle. Okay. From 0 to 90 we can call as acute angle. The angle which measures 90 degree is called right angle. From 90 to 190 we can call as obtuse angle. Are you clear? Yes. Now come to straight angle. Okay. The angle which measures 180 degree is called straight angle. One straight angle is equal to two right angle. Okay. For example, PQR is 180. Our protractor. Okay. It's 180. The base. Okay. Are you clear? So one straight angle is equal to how many right angles, ma? Please underline this. It's equal to two right angle. Here also measure an angle, right? Underline that an angle which measures between 90 degree to 180 degree is called as obtuse angle. Okay. Now come to the session. One straight angle is equal to two right angle. Okay. Please underline this. Right angle, obtuse angle, straight angle. The angle that measures 90 degree is right angle. An angle that measures more than 90 degree but less than 180 is obtuse angle. An angle that measures 180 degree is straight angle. Are you clear, guys? Please go through a very, very important session, types of angle. Okay. Next, come to the next session. Next type is reflex angle. Angle which measures between 180 and 360 is called reflex angle. So here in our protractor it contains 180. So below is called reflex angle. Okay. Are you clear? So an angle that measures more than 180 but less than 360 is called reflex angle. Please underline that. So an angle which measures 180 degree is called which angle, ma? If it is measures 180 degree, we can call this as a straight angle. Okay, please write that. Now, to find the reflex angle of a given angle, we subtract the given angle from 360. Okay, please underline this. Now, calculate the measure of the reflex angle 130. We want to measure the reflex angle of 130. If you want to find the reflex angle of 130, what do you want to do first? Just subtract with 360. Okay. So here our answer is one. Question is 130 degree. We want to find the reflex angle. Measure the reflex angle of 130. So should subtract that 360 degree minus 130 degree. So you'll get 230 degree. This 230 is the reflex angle of 130 degree. Okay, guys, are you clear? Next question. Next, the heading is complete angle. Okay, an angle in which one of the arm takes a full round and overlaps the another arm again is called complete angle. A complete angle measures 360 degree. Are you clear, guys? Okay, an angle. So already we seen that zero angle. Zero angle means when two arms are overlap. Here the thing is one full arm. So it comes like a full circle. Okay, just imagine like that. This semicircle is just like our protractor. So this is 190. So this is another 190. So entirely it is 360. Okay, this is a complete angle measures 360. That is, one of the arm take a full round and overlap the another again is called complete angle. Are you clear? Here you want to find the reflex angle. To find reflex angle, very simple. Subtract with 360 and write 360 degree and write the answer. So 360 degree minus 230 degree. What is the answer, ma'am? I'm already informing you, whenever you are doing like this, what do you want to do? And when I am doing search calculations, please do along with me. Sorry, it is 360 degree minus 260 degree. So what is the answer? It's 100 degree. Likewise, please do this also, okay? One complete angle measures how many mark? Complete angle means is 360 degree. Are you clear? Come to the next session is complementary angle, okay? If sum of two angle equal to 90 degree, they are said to be a complementary angle. See here, PQR measures 30 degree. PQR measures 30 degree as well as so here XY is Z as 60 degree. Now, so the angle PQR and XYZ together measures 90 degree. So we say that angle 30 is the complement of angle 60. Okay, angle Y is the complementary to angle X and vice versa. Okay, so both, if sum of two angles is equals 90 degree, we can set this as a complementary angle. Please underline this. Okay, our next session is supplementary angle. If sum of two angles is equal to 180, they are called as supplementary. So remember this two word. Complementary means sum of the two angle is equal to 90 degree for complementary angle. For supplementary angle, the sum of the two angles is equal to 180 degree. Please underline this. So please don't forget this. Okay, complementary angle, sum of the two angle is equal to 90 degree. Supplementary angle, sum of two angles is equal to 180 degree. Okay, are you clear? So here we can see, say that angle 130 is supplement of angle 50. Why? Because when you add this two, we will get 190. So the angle PQR and angle XY is together measures how much? Together measures how much, ma? 180. Okay, are you clear? So here you have a simple exercise for you. Identify the angles as acute, obtuse, right, straight, reflex, or complete angle without measuring them. Easily we can find them, right? So this is which angle, ma? Is that between, by seeing itself we can tell, right? It's between 0 to 90. So between 0 to 90 we can tell as which angle, ma? It is acute angle. Okay, so please try to fill this homework. Okay, very simple, and try to finish this. Okay, so this is which angle? This angle. This is straight angle. Next one. So I will tell you. So see here. See, it is more than 90. I'm right. 90 means just imagine L shape. So it is more than 90. So more than 90 is called which angle, ma? It is obtuse angle. So finish this too. Okay, guys. Are you clear? In page 72 also you have same thing. Classify the following. Angle as acute, obtuse, right, straight, reflex or complete angle. Okay, and you want to find the reflex angle also. Reflex angle, how to find reflex angle? If you want reflex, find reflex angle, subtract with 360. Okay, are you clear guys? 360 minus 65 degree. Likewise, you want to finish it. So 7.2 is a homework for you. Finish this 7.2 as well as 7.1. So 7.1, 7.2, please finish this. After finishing your works, please take a snapshot and send to me, okay? Whatever doubt you have, just call or text me. Okay, guys? Thank you. Take care. Bye.